Archaeologists in Egypt say they unearthed a tomb that hasn't been touched since it was sealed 4,400 years ago.
Yet another new tomb has been discovered in Egypt's Valley of the Kings in Luxor. It dates from pharaonic time.
Pada tahun 2018 lalu, para arkeolog di Mesir mengatakan mereka menemukan sebuah makam yang belum pernah disentuh sama sekali oleh manusia sejak disegel 4.400 tahun lalu. Penemuan itu berada di situs arkeologi Saqqara, selatan Kairo, Mesir. Menurut Kementerian Purbakala negara tersebut, mengatakan bahwa itu adalah makam pribadi seorang pendeta pemurnian kerajaan yang bertugas pada dinasti kelima Firaun.
Archaeologists in Egypt say they unearthed a tomb that hasn't been touched since it was sealed 4,400 years ago.
The shaft it leads to should be a coffin or a sarcophagus of the owner of the tomb.
The discovery was made at the Saqqara archaeological site south of Cairo. The country's Ministry of Antiquities says it's the private tomb of a royal purification priest who served during the 5th dynasty of the pharaohs. It was well preserved and hadn't been looted. The walls were lavishly decorated with hieroglyphs and statues, which are believed to depict scenes of the priest with his family. Archaeologists also say they found 5 shafts, which could hold many answers for them.
It explains a lot. Why didn't we find any objects for this guy? It means that his objects should be in those shafts. How about his burial chamber? Should be in a shaft. How about his treasures, his objects, his statues, his funerary furniture, stuff like this? Should be in the shafts.
This is the first tomb of its kind to be excavated in Egypt this year, and archaeologists say it's one of the more important finds they've made in decades. With more places to search inside the tomb, it seems they haven't finished discovering yet.
Selain makam tersebut, ada lagi makam lainnya yang diduga juga berasal dari peradaban Firaun abad ke-13 sebelum Masehi yang ditemukan di makam para raja Mesir di Luxor.
Yet another new tomb has been discovered in Egypt's Valley of the Kings in Luxor. It dates from pharaonic times around the 13th century BC, and it contains the mummified remains of a priest and his wife. Archaeologists also found a decorative sarcophagi and 1,000 statuettes. New technology, better mapping techniques, and renewed interest in Egypt's buried treasures have led to a number of recent finds.
We found a new mummified tomb with very nice paintings, colored paintings, with a depiction of the queen Ahmes Nefertari and their son Amenhotep I, both deified during the mummified period.
The latest treasure trove has revealed some remarkably well-preserved artifacts, with some of the paintings looking as fresh as if they'd just been finished. Egypt is keen to promote its heritage, following some poor years for tourism after terrorist outrages. Tourism is one of Egypt's biggest sources of foreign exchange.
Yang membuatnya menarik dari mumi ini ialah proses pemumiannya. Orang Mesir kuno memiliki metode khusus dan maksud tertentu untuk mengawetkan jenazah dalam bentuk mumi. Museum Getty pernah memberikan sebuah video animasi singkat tentang proses mumifikasi seorang pemuda Mesir kuno bernama Herakleides yang meninggal pada abad pertama Masehi ketika ia berusia 20 tahun.
This is a mummy of a young man named Herakleides. He died in Egypt in the 1st century AD when he was about 20 years old. Mummification was developed by the ancient Egyptians to preserve the body for the afterlife. Typically, all internal organs were removed before mummification, with the exception of the heart. But in this case, the heart was removed and the lungs were left intact. Next, the body was covered with salt and left for about 40 days until all moisture was eliminated. Perfumed oils and plant resins were rubbed on the body. Thick layers of resin were applied to glue the strips of linen that were wrapped around the body. The mummy was placed on a wooden board, and more wrappings bound them together. A mysterious pouch, perhaps of religious significance, was placed on the chest. A mummified ibis, a wading bird with a slender, down-curved bill, was placed on the abdomen. Ibis mummies commonly served as votive offerings to the gods, but this is an unusual case of a bird being mummified with a deceased human. Long linen strips further secured the wrappings. A portrait panel of Heraclides was placed over the face. A large linen cloth was wrapped around the mummy. The shroud was painted red with an imported lead-based pigment. This treatment is rare. Very few red shroud mummies are known to exist. Egyptian symbols of protection and rebirth were painted on the outer cloth with pigments and gold. Finally, Heraclides' name was written in Greek at the feet. Thanks to this remarkable mummification process, Heraclides' body is with us today.
Sahabat Aswaja, mengawetkan jenazah atau mumifikasi adalah bagian dari peradaban Mesir kuno. Sedangkan pengetahuan tentang peradaban Mesir kuno sebenarnya cukup penting bagi umat Islam. Sebab kata Mesir secara eksplisit disebutkan langsung di dalam kitab suci Al-Quran. Selain itu, di dalam Al-Quran juga terdapat uraian kisah dan kehidupan para nabi, di antaranya Nabi Yusuf, Nabi Musa, dan Nabi Harun yang diutus di Mesir, dan juga kisah yang masyhur tentang Raja Biadab Fir'aun. Lalu, mengenai alasan jenazah raja-raja Mesir kuno selalu diawetkan menjadi mumi, yakni berkaitan dengan kepercayaan yang mereka anut. Menurut laman The Guardian, proses mumifikasi adalah cara untuk mengubah orang mati menjadi bentuk yang diterima oleh para dewa. Akan tetapi, di dalam syariat Islam yang sempurna, proses pengurusan jenazah bukanlah dengan dijadikan mumi, sebab Allah dan Rasul-Nya telah mengajarkan kepada umat-Nya untuk menyegerakan pengurusan jenazah dan menguburkannya. Rasulullah SAW bersabda, "Apabila salah seorang dari kalian meninggal, janganlah kalian menyimpannya, tetapi segerakanlah penguburannya." Hadis riwayat At-Tabrani dan Al-Baihaqi. Maka dari itu, kita sebagai Muslim harus meyakini bahwa manusia diciptakan dari tanah dan akan kembali ke tanah. Sebagaimana firman Allah SWT dalam Al-Quran, "Darinya, tanah, itulah kami menciptakan kamu, dan kepadanyalah kami akan mengembalikan kamu, dan dari sanalah kami akan mengeluarkan kamu pada waktu yang lain." Al-Quran Surat Toha ayat 55. Wallahu a'lamu bis-shawab. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.